Okay, we got the visual. We're trying to see how many's in the pack and in here.
Copy that, 2 kilo, guard in.
Mexican wolves dwindled to within 7 animals of extinction. They were completely eradicated from the wild in the United States, and populations in Mexico were quickly dwindling when the Endangered Species Act became a thing in 1973, and it promulgated our efforts to go capture some of the last remaining wild Mexican wolves and start a captive breeding program to save the subspecies from extinction. We started reintroducing Mexican wolves into Arizona and New Mexico in 1998. It took several years for the population to start growing pretty in a healthy way, but for the past like 10, 12 years, the population's been growing at like 10, 15% a year. At the end of 2022, we documented a minimum of 242 wolves in Arizona and New Mexico, and we're currently counting wolves now to document the population for the end of 2023.
The annual count is a pretty exciting time. So starting November 1st, we go out onto the ground in the field and we try and get locations on the wolves and walk in and get a count on them. So a lot of times they'll sniff us out and take off and we don't get that count visually, but there's other ways to get it.
Looking at tracks, hearing howls, so all sorts of work in terms of counting and getting our best estimate going into 2 weeks of helicopter count and capture.
So the technique is once our fixed wing pilot locates the general area of the pack, the helicopter will come in and immediately the crew in the helicopter starts counting wolves. And we try to get an accurate pack count that way. Within that pack, is going to be targets, perhaps. Uncollared wolves, collars that are going bad, collars that need to be replaced. And so those are our target animals, and those are the ones we try to capture.
We have certain chase times so that the animal does not become too fatigued or hot. We have very strict parameters with the number of times we can chase, what kind of terrain we can chase, even ages. We have some elderly animals, we're like, nope, leave them alone.
Once we get a dart into that wolf, I write down the time and we'll be checking to see how long the animal is going to take to have those effects from the drug. And once that wolf does show the effects of the drug and lays down and starts taking a nap, then we'll find a place for the helicopter to land. And then I will jump out of the helicopter, go to the wolf, get a quick temperature on him, put a muzzle on it, and bring it back to the helicopter. And then we'll fly it over to that processing station to get a full workup.
Five-pound pup of the year. They have him. Can't put his head down on that end. Good strong heart rate. Use this thumb. That'll stabilize the vein. Yep, there you go.
We do complete physical exams on these animals and make sure they're healthy. We need to do easy things to them, radio collaring and vaccines. Liz, we've got penicillin in. It was 3 cc's of penicillin. And drawing blood and taking measurements.
Okay, he can lift his head up just a bit. Open up, drop his lower jaw. Teeth look like a pup of the year.
Don't hurt the animal. We could do that to your dog at a vet clinic. It's done much more efficiently and safely for both the animal and humans if they are immobilized with the drugs. Once they recover from the drug, we do release them back into their territory and they reunite with their pack mates.
Back in 1998, I saw the first two wolves being released into the wild. Last year, 2023, we had 242 wolves in the recovery area. So literally in the last, I'd say 7 or 8 years, we've seen exponential growth of the wolf population every year. So if we have continued growth like that, the success of the Mexican gray wolf being back on these United States soils is almost for sure certain gonna happen.